So number six, here's what you're told. There's a picture on page 179. And you are told here that L is equal to 1. R is equal to 10. And E is equal to 30 cosine 60t plus 40 sine 60t. So there's your forcing function. So in this case, they don't mention Q at all. So we make the assumption that there is no charge on the circuit at this time. So since Q is not mentioned, we're going to assume that the charge is zero. So really our equation is just going to become Li prime plus Ri is equal to E of t. Instead of a second order linear, this time we have a first order linear. L was 1, R is 10, now we haven't solved first order linear with a characteristic equation, but you can. What would be the characteristic equation for this one? So our characteristic equation here is just R plus 10. So R would have a value of negative 10. That means our characteristic solution is CE to the negative 10t. Does that repeat anything that's in my forcing function? So we can choose for our particular solution just A cosine 60t plus B sine 60t. What's our first derivative?
Negative 60t sine 60t.
Good. Okay, that's the first part. Mm-hmm. And we're going to put those back into our original equation, I prime plus 10i is equal to E of t. So when I put that back in, we're going to get negative 60A sine 60T plus 60B cosine 60T, and then multiply your original particular solution by 10, So you're going to get 10A cosine 60T plus 10B sine 60T. And we're told that that should equal our forcing function, which is 30 cosine 60T plus 40 sine 60T. So we start matching up coefficients. Let's start with cosine. We've got a 60B right here. And then we've got a 10A right here. And then over here we have a 30. So our first equation is going to be 60B plus 10A is equal to 30. And then we'll look at sine. So for sine, we have a negative 60A, a positive 10B, and then on the other side we have a 40. So any questions so far?
I mean, this is not really different from what we've been doing. How do we go about solving these two equations? What are our options?
What's that? Okay. Yeah, okay, can multiply by 6 to get rid of the A. So I'm going to multiply this top one by 6. Then I don't have to change the sign. And we'll turn the order around too. So this is going to give us 60A plus 360B is equal to 180. The second equation we don't need to change. So our A's cancel. We get 370B is equal to 220. So if I divide, these will both reduce by 10. So B is going to be 22 over 37. And then to get A, we can go back and say, 10A plus 60 times 22 over 37 is equal to 30.
I don't know off the top of my head what 60 times 22 is.
So let's go ahead and change 30 so that it has a denominator of 37 as well. That way we'll be able to combine. So we get that 10A and then you're going to multiply by 1/10 to get rid of that 10. So 10 will go into 210, 21 times. So this is A. All right, any questions so far? This is algebra. Okay, so that makes our particular solution. Negative 21 over 37 cosine 60T plus 22 over 37 sine 60T. And then we get to do all the fun trick to convert it to just a single cosine function. So remember your amplitude. Was the square root of a squared plus b squared. So in our case, this